the old mode of teaching, of sitting there and imparting via a careful outline, a series of facts, that really is passé. We have so many better ways to teach.
I'm a big believer if that human beings are in a room together, they should be interacting with each other. If you have 300 people in the room, at least in my mind, one of the worst things you could do is one person lecture to the other 299 people.
The field of medicine has changed a lot in the past 100 years, and that was about the last time that there was a major reform in medical education. And we know much more about learners and learning than we did 100 years ago.
People are connected to other people, and people are connected to information in all kinds of new ways that we never have been in the past. And the possibility for communicating and interacting and collaborating around those things is phenomenal.
We know that providing timely feedback to students is very important. We know that doing that in the context of practice allows them to make applications of what they're doing. We also know that learners learn from each other.
Put yourself in the mindset of a young person who's used to rapid ways to accrue information, that watches videos, plays games, and learns in a much different way than an older generation learned.
Everybody learns at a different pace. And we should respect that and let everyone learn at a different pace.
And what we're doing with a flipped classroom or an inverted classroom and what we're calling interactive learning is that we're taking the lecture out of the classroom.
Interactive learning really embodies a whole range of methodologies and pedagogies that really, where the goal is to have very tight engagement between the instructor and the learner and the material.
In interactive learning, the typical homework, the solving of puzzles, the working through issues, is actually done together with a variety of other people, so it's homework in the classroom. And the classic classroom stuff, which is being lectured to, learning facts, is done at home, either by watching videos or textbooks or so forth.
Well, there's one final thing that we have to put in here, and that is the popliteus. And you can see it's this thing.
The student on their own watches the video, which has been prepared in a way that can be interrupted, stop, run at 2x speed, with reading materials and online resources that are appropriate for that video to fill the gaps as needed. The student now comes to the classroom with curiosity, having been spurred on by watching the video in advance, is given an engaging vignette or problem, a multi-station exercise, or some other active learning exercise. They have had their curiosity piqued by the video, and now they're engaging with their peers and their faculty member in a back and forth, dynamic, engaging learning environment.
This is a holistic methodology that has both online and offline components, neither one of which can live on its own. So the objective is to put these things together to make a complete educational experience.
At first I was a little bit skeptical. I do like going to lecture and being able to ask the professor questions and just being, I guess, having that person in front of me to keep me engaged while I learn. But actually ended up really liking the interactive activities. I thought it was a great way to reinforce some of the concepts rather than just trying to passively take it in.
I find that my colleagues and I do learn better when we have something at stake in the conversation. For the classes where we've been forced to sit down with a concept and actually create our own ideas about it, I don't have to go back and study those later because I learned the first time.
I think what we found so far is that not only were students very receptive to the idea, but they really enjoyed it. And I think a lot of them now are kind of expecting this to be the new paradigm in a lot of their other courses because they see a lot of benefits from it. And I think it is true that it takes a lot of work up front to make a good interactive session. Overall, I'm not sure that it does take more work, and the students really were engaged.
There are many resources that we are developing to help faculty think through strategies, and those include the resources embedded within the Office of Medical Education, resources within our ed tech department, and university resources, especially through the Center for Teaching and Learning. So we're going to be developing strategies with all of those groups.
The intent here at the School of Medicine is really to be thoughtful about how this is done and make sure that the entire 360 degrees of the methodology is taken into account, understood, measured for efficacy, and really approached in, again, a highly thoughtful and holistic way.
You know, the idea of interactive learning, or, that's what the Socratic method is, none of this is new ideas we're talking about now. But we're excited that, one, a major institution like Stanford is really rethinking its curriculum in a serious way, and really kind of buying into this, we should make class time much more interactive. But then with the other side of it, and why I'm interested in medical education, is that content, when it goes out to the rest of the world, it's going to make people better physicians.
The biggest challenge that I see, but one of the greatest advantages of the interactive classroom, is that it provides an opportunity to make classroom learning fun. Fun. And it should be fun. We're bringing together all these talented people, both students and teachers. Everyone loves to learn. Teachers like to teach. But I think what's happened is the classroom no longer is fun. And so the biggest revolution we can create is to make the classroom fun. And it's fun to teach. It's fun to have exercises where you come out of it feeling like, wow, I really learned something. And when you finish a session that has been fun, what you find is that the teacher is invigorated, the students are exhilarated, and that's what the classroom's all about. There's no reason, given the talent pool and the fact that we all want to become excellent doctors and have the best knowledge base we can, that the classroom should not be fun. And I think that's the greatest advantage, and that's what we can offer with the interactive classroom going forward.
The preceding program is copyrighted by the Board of Trustees of the Leland Stanford Junior University. Please visit us at med.stanford.edu.